Taking notes and getting ideas out of your brain is of the utmost importance, not only when it comes to being in meetings or class, but also for letting your mind do its best work on a day-to-day basis. As many of you know, I like to use Notion and apps overall when it comes to note-taking, but with so many different note-taking applications, it's hard to choose what app you should be using. In this video, however, I asked for help from a friend of mine who is not only a fellow content creator, but a note-taking enthusiast on what he considers to be the best note-taking app. 2021. Before we dive into those apps, however, I think it would be best for him to explain what the different methods and reasonings for taking notes may be.
Thank you, Dimitri, for having me on the channel. And what I'm going to talk about is tools for thought, then collaboration of notes and expression of ideas. And the reason I'm looking over to the side is because I'm actually reading my notes. And I want to make it obvious in this that I'm reading my notes because we don't all know everything, but I have a couple of bullet points that I want to go through. So tools of thought. What are tools for thought? Essentially, they're scrappy notes. They're unorganized notes. They're things that you just jotted down. Maybe that's on your phone, on your computer or something like that. And you need to have them somewhere, but not organized in a database or organized in a folder system somewhere. Miles down in loads of folders. They're just scrappy, disorganized notes that you want to put down and make sure that you don't forget. That could be the number of something or the name of something. Maybe if you're an academic like myself, you need to find a reference for something or you've noted something in a lecture. And the tools for thought is essentially the ability to put everything down, put everything in one place, but then link it together in some way. So maybe you've got a couple of different phone numbers and you put that in a contacts page. Maybe there's a different references, couple of different references for a certain point, and you want to try and collect them and merge them all together whilst keeping them somewhat separate so you can find exactly what you're looking for when you want to find it, which means tool for thought need to have a fairly competent, useful search feature that you can use. Then when it comes to the collaboration tools, it's a little bit different because you're working with someone else. You need one, in my opinion, an ability to see what other people are doing, what other people are typing, where they are. So something like Google Docs or Notion, I'm sure we'll go into some apps later on, where you can see where the other person is working so you don't either cut and copy what they're doing or you can see what they're working on at that time. So it's an ability to see what they're doing when they're doing it. So live action note taking, but also that you can see it wherever you are. It doesn't matter where you are, what you're doing. You can work sort of like remotely with other people. That's what collaborative note taking tools, I think, does, so that you can work from wherever, whenever, and see what is going on all over the place. And then we have the expression of tools, the expression of notes, which most of the time is going to be in like short blog posts or shorter articles, maybe even longer articles as well. Most likely longer articles in academic spaces. There will be essays and formal articles, maybe even published papers. And those sort of tools, most of the time, you don't need the collaborative work because it's yourself. But you do need an ability to see the content page, because if they are longer, you need to be able to navigate up and down those pages, and you just need really basic text editing. When I'm working with expression tools, I make sure I can get everything down on the piece of paper or on the page so that it's all written out and it's planned out, but I don't want loads of other things going on, loads of other links going on, because then I can start to get sidetracked. Now, even though I say that, all three of these types, so tools for thought, exploration, and collaboration tools, or note-taking, the tool could be, you could have one tool for two of those things and one of the other thing, or you could have a tool that does all three. It's very dependent on the features that the individual, i.e. yourself, is looking for, from my experience, because some people in their tools for thought don't need a load of backlinks, don't need a load of references and block references and loads of other features. They don't need it. So their tool for thought is very, very similar to their collaboration tool, or very, very similar to their expression tool. So it also depends on the features that you require in that stage of your process in your note taking, whether it is right at the start and you're just grabbing stuff down in that tool for thought area, or you're starting to collaborate and work with other people. Maybe you're just working by yourself and you go from tools for thought to expression. You completely skip the collaboration because you're not working with other people. But there is certainly a stage where you go tool for thought, grabbing stuff, making something from it, the bottom-up note-taking, collaboration, I'm going to work with other people, and then expression, okay, this is what we're going to do, this is what we're going to share, this is what I know, let it out into the world.
Thank you again, Danny, for all that good information on the different types of note-taking. We'll be hearing from him again, so stay tuned for that. But I will say that it's been awesome to bounce ideas off of you for the past few years, so Thanks for everything there. If you want to go check out Danny's stuff, please go check him out. He should be in the description down below. If he comments on this video, I will also probably pin his comment. So now with the three different use cases broken down regarding what different types of note-taking there are, let's dive into those three apps. But before we do that, please make sure to hit that like button, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to stay up to date with all of my latest videos. Without further ado, let's dive into those apps.
So Notion is definitely my favorite app of choice for the collaboration of notes concept. And here's the thing, example of why this app is great for collaborative notes. It's because if we look at the podcast and what we consistently do in the podcast is the fact that I have this outline of notes with Chance and we will literally just bounce ideas off each other. As you can see, his icon is here in the corner over here. And what's going on is you're seeing a space where Chance can edit this, I can edit this, and we did this as we were talking. As we were talking on it, we were typing very quietly during the podcast to try to like bounce off new ideas and would write where we're wanting to go, and it helped guide the conversation, and that's amazing. And then the last thing is, when Danny and I scripted, or when I scripted this video and then sent Danny what I wanted to do, he was able to quickly see what everything was, and you can see everything in orange is Danny's. And then when he saw that, we collaborated on adding a new part to the video that was important, so that we can do some further explanation on it. And that's, I mean, that's impressive. And that brings us to the next part of things, which Danny's gonna bounce off of for the Obsidian part of everything. Ideas and would write where we're wanting to go, and it helped guide the conversation, and that's amazing. And then the last thing is, when Danny and I scripted, or when I scripted this video and then sent Danny what I wanted to do, he was able to quickly see what everything was, and you can see everything in orange is Danny's. And then when he saw that, we collaborated on adding a new part to the video that was important, so that we can do some further explanation on it. And that's, I mean, that's impressive. And that brings us to the next part of things, which Danny's going to bounce off of for the Obsidian part of everything.
So best tool for thought, obviously best is going to be subjective and it's going to be context specific. For me personally, as I mentioned earlier, there are different features that I don't necessarily need, but I prefer to have in a tool for thought. Now, there are loads of tool for thought. Notion is a collaboration / tool for thought. I personally don't use it because it doesn't have some of the features that Obsidian does have. Rome does have some of the features Obsidian has, but doesn't have other features. So let's go through some of those features. So backlinks and unlinked references. Backlinks, lots of tools are starting to develop that feature. They have backlinks. Unlinked references, not as many tools have unlinked references, but there's still lots of them there. So having backlinks and unlinked references allows me to see what notes link, what notes could link, and what I have already made the links for. So when I'm working in academics and I have 7 or 8 different references, I want to know, okay, what point, what paragraph, what article, what section of the thing that I'm doing, the thing that I'm writing, or the working note that I'm making, where does these points in these references link up? And that's where the backlinks and unlinked references become really useful. Obsidian is also one of the only apps that I have found that allows you to have multiple pages open at once. So most applications, most tools, require you to either have another tab open, so maybe you're on your browser and you've got like 7 or 8 tabs open for whatever the tool is. Some tools do give you like a side panel, a side tab, which is great, but Obsidian allows you to have as many as you want. So if you've got a really big screen, you could have loads of pages open. You could have them vertical, so you could have 3 different pages or 4 different pages, 5 if you really want. You can have loads going across, so you could have a grid of different pages all across your space, all across your screen, and you can work on any of them at any time that you want. So you can work with loads of different things going on. So if you have 6 references, you can have the 6 references up on one side, then you can have your main working page in the middle, and then you can have something else on the side, and you can go between them rather than having to go in and out of those pages. You can just see them all at once and scroll where you need to, copy and paste over, and it just makes workflows of making notes, making articles, making anything in written word much, much easier.
So when it comes to expression of ideas for note-taking, let's dive into what really was the main thing that probably can showcase what I'm talking about. So I wrote an ebook last year, and in expression of ideas, I mean, you know, Microsoft Word, it's pretty amazing that it's something that so many people use on a day-to-day basis, and you might be surprised, like Microsoft Word, really? That's what we're gonna use? But I wrote an entire ebook based off of the fact that this works so well. So I can see here, I have my final draft, right? And we have the entire, all the pages here, and I have the written pages, but in the first draft, you can see I had every single step of the way written. So each and every page here is going to be different than the last. It's each chapter of the book, and there is, in my opinion, no better app that really can just help you express the ideas how you want it to and look at it in a nice overall sense. So if we go into the final draft of everything and I go into the Word document here, I kind of have the overall view because I put a bunch of headers and whatnot. So another great part about Microsoft Word for the expression of ideas is the fact that we can put in something like a table of contents and have all of those things grouped together. So obviously I inserted this. You can do that by going to references and inserting a table of contents. But if we go to the view section here and press the navigation pane, then we can see that this is broken down in a nice way, and I can really see what ideas I put out there. And honestly, just having Microsoft Word, it's a simple application. It's something where you're gonna have the expression of ideas take place, and it's pretty free-flowing there. Like, it's only for writing, it's only for getting things out. There's no distractions outside of it. And that's why I think Microsoft Word, when it comes to expressing the ideas you wanna get out, is the best option for it.
When it comes to sharing the information that you have, sharing the notes, maybe that's through a collaboration tool like Notion, Obsidian. Yes, I am biased towards Obsidian, but you can use Obsidian to share all the information. So instead of writing it out in Word document, which in my opinion is probably the best document, the best tool to make longer documents, I personally use Obsidian for my expression tool for shorter documents. But for longer documents, I use Word because it's just better. It's just better to be able to go up and down. From my experience, I could do it in Obsidian, but personal preference. But when it comes to sharing all that information, obviously Word, you're gonna have to upload it to a website or upload it to something. But Obsidian, you can do it straight away. And one of the benefits of using Obsidian as publish, so Obsidian publish to share those notes up, is you can share all of the stages of the work, and it's very, very simple just to save and update. Essentially, when I'm going through my Obsidian, I'm going to have all of my pages, all of my notes. I have my capture notes, which are essentially my reference notes. So they are the videos that I've taken. I have my processing notes, which are all the notes that I have sort of bunched a load of stuff together in, but I haven't like condensed it into something that's worth sharing. But some people are interested in my process or interested in some of the things that I found. So I still want to share those bits, but not necessarily share those bits as a fully fledged finished article, because it's not a finished article. They're just working notes. But it does help, from feedback I've got from the community, it does help for them to see what points I have and the different stages of those notes. And then I have my working notes, which are fully condensed notes. Again, you can see this on Obsidian Publish, but as a kind of like closing remark on that, you don't have to share everything. I share everything personally. Well, I share almost everything. I share my journal, I share all of my notes, but you don't need to share anything. And just because you're creating something doesn't mean you need to share something. But what I would say is we are all creating something. We're all creating ideas. We're all creating notes. We're all making notes. So if you're going to use the notes for something useful, you need to do something with it. Whether that's create something for yourself, create a video for yourself, create a journal for yourself, create a Word document for yourself, or an article for yourself, just something. Do something with the ideas. Do something with the thoughts to make sure that the thoughts don't go, just don't get lost into space, because then you end up having the same thought over and over again, and yeah, that's just not fun, because then you end up getting stuck in your head. So I'll leave you to Dimitri.
Thanks again, Danny, for being part of this video. It's been awesome to have those different types of people in the community to bounce ideas off of, and you've been one of those people that I've known the longest since I've been on the platform. So kudos to you for everything you do, and thanks again for being a part of this video. If you guys liked this video, please make sure to check out any of my other ones over here. But first, make sure to go check out Danny's channel. With that being said, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.